Okay, my fourth one will be... The dark story of an adopted girl that had a secret. Uh-oh. There's nothing wrong with that. Me, I don't want a big family. I want like small 3 kids and that's it. I would too.
Excited to learn.
She didn't get any.
Esther was extremely bright, and she made incredible progress. By the time she was 5, she began to be able to communicate in vocal sentences. She spoke enough English to get her into preschool that year. Counselors had told the couple that getting her into school as soon as possible was important, so that she could learn how to communicate and interact with other little kids her age. Even though Ava and Henry that their new daughter was bullied in school because she had grown up very differently than the other kids, she did surprisingly well and had no problems making friends. As Esther grew and progressed academically, she began to share what her life was like before she had this problem. This all started when she started kindergarten and was asked to draw a picture of her family. She drew a picture of her mother, herself, and 3 other small children. It was clear as soon as she brought the picture adopted parents were nowhere in her picture. Because of how hard they had been trying to make her feel like a part of their family, this was painful to see. The couple gently asked Esther about her old life. The little girl slowly opened up, and her story was enough to break anyone's heart. She talked about the poor village she was from and the tiny shack her family of 6 multiplied. She and her
6 kids.
She talked very fondly about her mom, explaining how her mom did everything she possibly could for her family, even going days without food so that her children could eat. Even still, there were many nights that Esther had gone to bed with her belly rumbling. With tears running down her face, the little girl described how her baby sister Nadia would scream and cry at night because she was starving. Esther began to hide her own food so that she could give it to her baby sister.
Buddy, be nice.
Her stomach aching day after day. All of this information was absolutely heartbreaking to Henry and Ava. But they couldn't help but notice that one person
was going to get you, buddy.
She never once mentioned her father. When they eventually brought this up to her, tears formed in Esther's eyes and a strange expression crossed over her face. Almost like the mention of the word father was enough to traumatize her and bring back a terrible memory. Esther explained that things had gotten particularly bad in her village a couple of years ago. Due to sickness, it was hard for her family to get basic necessities they needed to survive. Her father was her worst nightmare. He was a cruel and selfish man who thought only of himself and not of his family. He often abused Esther's siblings. Esther did everything she could do to protect her siblings, even putting herself in between them and her angry, violent father at the time. At this point in the story, Esther was sobbing so hard that she could barely speak, and she ran out of the room. Ava and Henry decided they would not bring up Esther's father again, unless she wanted to talk about him. While they were tucking her into bed a few days later, the little girl suddenly began telling them the horrific ending. Her brow furrowed in concentration, as if she was determined not to cry. She explained that in order to save the rest of the family, her father sacrificed her and decided to sell her to a local human trafficking ring. The last memory she had of her family was her mother sobbing as her father ripped her from her mother's arms and passed her off to other bad men. One of the bad men had felt sorry for Esther, and while the rest of the arrived with her at the shelter home, nobody asked him any questions. As soon as he dropped her off, he quickly disappeared off into the night. Ava and Henry were completely heartbroken and devastated. As much as the couple loved their daughter and couldn't imagine losing her, they knew they had to put her happiness before their own. It was time to help their little girl reunite with her family. The couple worked with the adoption center to eventually track down Esther's family. They traveled with Esther back to Queen and were able to reunite her with
her family. Alright guys, I will see my fifth video, so I see you then.